Hello everyone, and welcome to my latest movie review, which will be on The Adventures of Tintin, that was released in 2011, directed by Steven Spielberg. So, rest assured for those of you that don't like spoilers in any shape or form, you'll be glad to know this is a non-spoiler review, so I'll keep plot details and character info to an absolute minimum. So, the story naturally follows Tintin, played by Jamie Bell, a reporter who comes at a city market one day and becomes immediately fascinated when he comes across the Unicorn model ship. Despite some attention from other prospective buyers such as Saccharin, played by Daniel Craig, Tintin successfully purchases the model ship. Tintin and Snowy then discover a parchment scroll located within the Unicorn ship. This thrusts Tintin and Snowy on an adventure that spans several locales throughout the world, including an encounter with a sea captain called Captain Haddock, as they try to find the treasure of the Unicorn ship before the evil Saccharin does. Now, despite me being a huge Tintin fan, I had to put that to one side when reviewing this film. Some of the questions I asked myself when reviewing this film were, is the story any good? Is it well directed? Is it well acted? And is the soundtrack any good, since I'm a huge film score fan as well? And thankfully, the answer to all of those questions is a resounding yes. The story is a brilliantly told adventure, with many scenes revealing key plot elements without the use of heavy exposition dialogue. There's a great scene early on in the movie when Tintin visits Marlinspike Hall after he suspects that Saccharin may have stolen his Unicorn model ship. Despite the fact that Tintin asks lots of questions to Saccharin to find out more about the Unicorn model ship, it never feels out of place in the story due to the fact that he's a reporter by trade. And by the screenwriters using Tintin's profession as a way for the audience to learn more about the Unicorn ship, it feels organic and natural to the story and never forced or contrived at any point whatsoever. Now, for any fans of Indiana Jones, including myself, you'd be glad to know that Tintin takes several cues from that franchise. This is evident in the exciting and fast-paced nature of the movie, along with the adventurous nature of the story as well. There's a great scene when we see Tintin and Captain Haddock stranded on a boat in the middle of the sea. Whilst the scene is mostly played for laughs with Captain Haddock's drunken behaviour, it's also great at propelling the story forward as well. This is evident when Tintin asks Captain Haddock about his backstory with regards to his ancestry, and going back to the inquisitive nature of the character, it never feels forced or contrived. And as a result, it's a great balance of the comedic aspects of the movie, whilst at the same time never forgetting the wider story at hand. The acting in this movie is great across the board, and everyone involved in the movie pretty much brings their A game. Jamie Bell is fantastic in the role of Tintin, and boyish and charismatic are the words that come to mind when describing his performance. And because Jamie Bell is great at conveying the determination of his character to get to the bottom of the story, it makes us as an audience just as determined to solve the mystery at hand. Andy Serkis is brilliant in the role of Captain Haddock, and he might just have the best performance in the movie as well. And that's because, without spoiling anything, Captain Haddock has the biggest character arc of the movie. When we first see Captain Haddock in the movie, he's very drunk, bumbling, and he's pretty much all over the place. And Andy Serkis does a great job of conveying those qualities in a very realistic way. And because of the character arc that the screenwriters wrote for Captain Haddock, it allows Andy Serkis to convey the character in a very three-dimensional way. Daniel Craig brings a layer of wit and charm to the role of Saccharin, and follows the great tradition of Hollywood casting British actors in villainous roles, which, incidentally, Daniel Craig said about the role prior to the movie. In this movie, Daniel Craig is suitably maniacal and deceitful, though thankfully never veering towards moustache twirling. Now, for any haters out there of motion capture technology, I think this might be the movie that puts any doubts that you've had about the medium to rest. And that's because the way Steven Spielberg helms the action, which, if I might say so, is nothing less than exceptional given what he's achieved so far in his career. He achieves a lot of things using this medium that's only possible with the tools at his disposal. One of my favourite set pieces in the movie is when Tintin and Snowy are captured on board the Caribou ship. In particular, when Tintin is being chased by Saccharin's crew, Steven Spielberg frames the action through a combination of low angles, close-ups and wide shots all in a very short amount of time. And this elaborate action scene, as well as the action as a whole really, shows you that when you've got a calibre of filmmaker like Steven Spielberg, and the wealth of tools at his disposal, which in this case is the motion capture medium, you get what I like to call cinematic gold. Oh, and by the way, when you get to that Bagar chase scene in the movie, there is some crazy shit that happens in this portion of the movie, so when you watch it for the first time and you get to this part of the movie, you'll know exactly what I'm talking about. The soundtrack from John Williams is nothing less than what you expect from the maestro at this point in his career. For any film score fans out there, thematic material is aplenty in this movie. Starting off with Tintin's title theme, which appropriately plays during the cartoony opening credits of the movie. What the title theme does magnificently well is how it captures the suspense and mystery of the Tintin mythology. There's also plenty of character themes in this movie as well, with themes for Snowy and Captain Haddock. These themes are great at conveying the unique personality traits of both characters. Snowy's theme is fantastic at conveying the brave nature of his character in aiding Tintin on his many adventures, whilst Captain Haddock's theme is appropriately bumbling when we see the drunken state of the character for the first time in the movie. Overall, it's a fantastic soundtrack from John Williams that perfectly captures the boisterous and adventurous nature of the story. The only major negative I had with the movie is how it takes literal pit stops from the adventurous nature of the story. This mainly relates to the scenes involving Captain Haddock's backstory and ancestry. And whilst I didn't necessarily have a problem with these scenes per se, I felt that if this aspect of the story was a bit more condensed, And if we got back to the adventurous nature of the story a bit more sooner, then I think the movie probably would have benefited from a runtime point of view. So overall, I'm going to give The Adventures of Tintin a solid 8 out of 10. What was some of the best motion capture technology you're likely to see? A compelling and well-told adventure story, and great performances across the board from Jimmy Bell, Andy Serkis, and Daniel Craig. The Adventures of Tintin is an adventure that you definitely don't want to miss. So, and I hand it over to you guys. I'm interested to hear your thoughts in terms of whether or not you enjoyed Tintin, and where do you think this movie ranks in terms of the animation and adventure genres? So, interested to hear your thoughts in the comment section below. So if you enjoyed this movie review, hit the like and subscribe buttons, and be sure to hit the notification bell for updates on the latest videos. I'm also available on social media, so if you want to get updates on the latest movie blog articles and the latest videos, you can follow me on Twitter, Instagram and Facebook, so I post links to all of those in the YouTube description below. I hope you enjoyed this movie review, and as always, I look forward to seeing you guys in the next one.